All right, everything seems to still work. So here we go, live with a bit more Dead by Daylight. Unusual for me to stick with the game for more than 3 days, I know. But we seem to be having a pretty good time here. So why not let those good times roll? And I'm actually curious about something. Do I have any killers who I basically haven't touched who don't have Iron Maiden? No. Even Shape has Iron Maiden 1. Which I suspect is due to the fact that I have Legion at Prestige 1. So that kind of supports my theory. Let's remember this, though. Shape has Iron Maiden at Tier 1. So, if I can push Legion, who is halfway there already, up to Prestige 2, will the Shape's Iron Maiden automatically upgrade? Actually, I might be able to answer this question faster if we look at Phil. Because if you look at Phil's little circle here around his 1, he is 3 levels away from Prestige 2. So if we can find someone that has Predator, Bloodhound, or Shadowborn 1, then we can check if those perks upgrade. Looks like Predator's off the table for the Shape. There's Lightborn, not the one I want. Shadowborn 1, and I've already forgotten the other one. If I can't remember the 2 perks off the top of my head, that's not going to make a very good test, is it? Bloodhound. Shadowborn and Bloodhound. What does Shape have for Bloodhound? 2. Alright, so that means we'll be looking at Shadowborn. Shape has Shadowborn 1. So we'll come over here to Wraith. Burn a bunch of blood points, and see if the Shape automatically goes to Shadowborn 2. Oh, he got that perk. By the power of science! What else? I want this. Two more Coxcomb. Alright. Prestige 2. The following perks have been unlocked at level 2 for all killers. You know, if I ever stopped to read this, I wouldn't have to do this test. There it is. Shadowborn is automatically leveled to 2. Today's experiment was brought to you by my inability to read. Man, listen to that twang. We have Lightborn, Tinkerer. Modern Abuse is an interesting choice. And then Brutal Strength. I have 2 comfort perks that recover better after bouncing off objects. Because Hillbilly does that. What is this overdrive? Hold the power button to chainsaw sprint. Sprints cause instant downs. Revving and sprinting cause overdrive to increase. When the meter is full, you charge and sprint faster, and cooldown is reduced for 20 seconds. Huh. It used to be that the chainsaw would overheat and go into cooldown. Why did they then go in the opposite direction? Now Tinker can only trigger once on each gen. Or maybe it was always like that. Well, distressing, which will make it more difficult for the survivors to tell where we really are. And then Brutal Strength is probably going to have to be replaced by another information-based perk. I will never find anyone. Discordance. That. Well, let's see what Hillbilly can do. I believe Hillbilly's real name is Max Thompson. And I don't remember why his face looks like that. But Johan, you just can't ask people why their face looks like that. Queue time seems to be going a bit long here. Apex Muffler is a scary add-on. Silent Chainsaw for survivors outside the terror radius. It doesn't work with our currently chosen perks because I've increased my terror radius size, but that's a spooky idea. Here we go. Found a game. Looks like we're going up against some newer survivors. They don't have prestige circles. Which kind of works for me, because I have not played Hillbilly in a long time. Certainly not since his multiple reworks, and I was never good at him to begin with. Which is probably rather telling, because at one time, Hillbilly was generally considered to be the best killer in the game. Reduced our hooks. Maybe these survivors are a bit more experienced than their profiles would otherwise indicate. If they are increasing our distance between hooks, that could suggest a sabotage build or another hook-proof plan play. Drop into the unfamiliar Toba Landing. Discordance has given us information. Bill has given us his face. They are inexperienced. She made a good effort, but didn't really seem to have much of a plan, and had no idea how to keep me in her line of sight. I guess this means we'll be at a fairly even match because I keep losing track of these people. Aha! That was not even a fast vault. Why am I vaulting? We are definitely losing too much time here. Far, far too much time. Suddenly switching tack to Bill has given us a down. Which is more progress for us than continuing to chase Meg. That looked like sprint burst. She got a lot of ground off of that. No. Whoops. That's the trouble with the same space bar being used. Yeah, space bar, the same key being used for pick up pinball. I don't know what that is, but I don't know, I'll find out. I still know what that is. So much... Bill? Why have you wasted that pallet? Why is Bill being strange? He wasted the pallet and walked directly into me. Seems he is learning, or maybe he was just good to begin with. Then again, maybe not. We don't judge. Kind of a noise notification. No idea what that could have been. That is a faraway gen. I don't even want to patrol that one. Hello. Fancy meeting you here. This is beginning to feel a bit unfair in my favor. I think the survivors truly are as inexperienced as they initially appeared. Hello, Bill. Ow. Yeah, you should probably start running. And dead end? I have no idea where this is. Or why it's even there. Now we have discordance. Tell us that there are some friends this way. Ah! The chainsaw's turning radius is very inconsistent. Once I get going, I move the mouse only slightly, and he just flicks a huge amount directly to the nearest wall. Oh, they got one. But Tinkerer didn't trigger. Weird. Or maybe it didn't, that's why I caught out Fang. Wild swinging. I don't know what that was. It does seem the thing is learning in real time. Respectable. Suppose I look away and oh, here she is. And it seems that's my 100th survivor hit. First hit of the match, 100th hit total. Tells you how often I use Hillbilly. Two down, two to go, and we now know where at least one is. Where'd they go? Aha. Ding! Kinda difficult to chainsaw in these close quarters. Waiting at a pallet has reset our distance. Not the best move by her. Crunch. I abandon her for this. Ow. And bang into things. Hello. She definitely has sprint burst. And is panicking. Window. There's the Claudette as well. Missed. How'd I miss? Where'd she go? It was a good dodge by her, if it was deliberate. It was also, to an extent, me being dumb. So, half credit? Partial credit? There she is. She's gonna play around the shack. Or not. Long distance is where I'm strongest. I couldn't open that locker to get her. Was she? I haven't seen that move before. So that was a deliberately slow locker entry? In any case, now we have to find Meg. Who it does not seem is going for the save. I've seen a lot of fast locker entries performed as a means of trying to dodge a hit, but I haven't seen one done so slowly before. Survivors have been known to fast vault into lockers to dodge a swing, which works. I just don't always swing, so they kind of waste the dodge sometimes. Oh. Hello. Just trying to hide in the corner? That's not pleasant behavior. Bonked our head there. Double pip with Max Thompson. So why doesn't it show? So this is my matchmaking rank, right? I'm in gold 3. Why doesn't it show their matchmaking rank anymore? You used to be able to see it. That way, if I was, say, a bronze 3 killer against a whole bunch of iridescent survivors, which used to happen, then I could look at it and go, okay, so that's why I lost. But now all you get to see is the prestige rank of the currently played character, which doesn't tell you anything about the player's level of skill. Kind of a strange choice. Well, we only need one more kill for this challenge. And more blood points. This is the lowest our blood points have been all week. I think it's time to get Artist finally at the Prestige 1. Nothing wrong with leaning on a personal favor. Of course, that's what her weapon is supposed to look like normally. I've been using this one, which I forget where I picked up. I think it came from the Rift when the Artist was new. The kind of crown of thorns there reminds me a bit of Darkest Dungeon. She's got this hood of crow skulls and whatever those spikes are. She's just a strange person. For she's one. Which gives everyone whatever that is. Grim Embrace. Each time a survivor's hooked for the first time, gain a token. Move 16 meters away from the hook, all gems are blocked. For 8 seconds. On 4 tokens, it blocks all gems for 40 seconds. And highlights the obsession. And that only happens once. Oh, no, the perk itself dies. So that's an anti-camping reward taken to the extreme. We are still in Discordance and Gen Kicking mode. Which is certainly a fine perk set. Maybe if Grim Embrace wasn't tier 2, if I had it at tier 3, I would use it. Call of Brine would probably be the best one to replace. In fact, I need to replace it anyway because I have the yellow information problem again. Both Call of Brine and Discordance still highlighting gens in yellow for completely different reasons. I'll just say Haunted Ground. Could be funny. Could be funny. Haunted Ground is a trap hex perk. Oh, interesting. Hatching the Killer Shack and going to Crota's Pren. Who wants to go to Crota's Pren? Anyway, Hex Haunted Ground is a trap hex perk. It activates two totems, making them glow and giving the survivors the impression that I have a hex perk. If either hex totem is cleansed, however, it explodes and every survivor becomes exposed. Oh. Hello, horse. Fancy spawning right next to you here. Anyway, we give them a few moments to kind of coordinate themselves and decide what they're doing. Check this gen person out. And deploy birds to the most distant checks. For 2 hits, causing panic. Oh no, she did go this way. I just got lost. While we're chasing her, we will bird that gem to sow a little panic. I don't think I disrupted them very much. No, they don't seem to really care that the birds happened. And they finish the gen despite the burns. Scouts go out. Find someone else. Just came off the basement hook. And whoever I have birded here got away. Hello. Why are you suddenly here, David? Generally a good plan to run directly in front of a killer. I had no idea who was there until he appeared. Oh, they finished that gem. I got my birds cleared off in record time. More panic. More David. Hello. Completely lost track of that Meg. Not enough pallet for the two of them. Yeah, I was focused on trapping the pallet. Oh. Hello, David. He walked directly into the bird and got birded. Two survivors up. This gen is nearly done, which doesn't really worry me. Yeah, David is a very, very loud boy for for supposedly a British backstreet brawler and football player. No hits on bird. That's still sparking. We have something here. Also, no. There was a noise notification over here. Maybe it was Zarina's red herring perk, since that gen is silent. Oh ho. We see someone, though. Aha. Excuse me. And that's why we use nowhere to hide. Because survivors like to be sneaky. Hello. You're gonna do the locker thing again? It didn't work last time. Why? Why would you go back into the same locker that I already peeled you out of? On Burn Scouts. No information from nowhere to hide. No hits on those Bird Scouts either. Was I really three kills deep and I didn't pay attention to the hatch at all? Well, that one is certainly on me. One, two, three. Yeah, I just forgot how numbers work. Well played to Steve. Anyway, there's our 12 kills. We upgrade our thing. It's a charm. By completing, we move on into the next stage. 12 hooks of different survivors. That is a minimum of 4 games. Sorry, 3 games. Again, I don't know how numbers work. This has just been established. As for the Rift Reward is crowing about, that's absolutely more blood points. Yeah, 2 more levels, then we get a jacket from Meg. Is there anything actually good in here? An owl mask for the Huntress. You know, I don't even play Huntress, but that looks nice. Maybe we could even get this deep in the tome track, whatever they call this, in the rift. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 levels later, we get some very oriental looking armor. It says battered breastplate, but there isn't even a breastplate here. It's just a kimono and a plated arm piece. And I guess that's supposed to go with the owl, because that's how these work. And the axe to go with it is way down here, past two more charms. And the axe... I basically own that axe. Not in-game, obviously. I have it on my wall somewhere. It doesn't even look great on her. It's a bit too simplistic, and the textures look a little blurred. Anything else of value in here? A hairstyle for Yunjin. Pants for Yunjin. Very distressed, very purple. More charms. I mean, yeah, if it's a cosmetic that I'm going to be spending time earning, then it had better be worth my time. Especially if it's going to be this deep on the track. It's a lot of time investment for something very lackluster. Whoa. Now that's a clown head. And it's floppy. And it goes with... Look, Ma, I'm Pagliacci. And what a knife that is. How can they make a knife so small look so cruel? That thing can't have a scabbard. There's no way. Well, let's carry on with our hook challenge here. Do I want to continue with Artist, fun as she is? Do I need to prestige someone else? It no longer matters. We can't change now. Another Renato. Remember, our last Renato was rude and very, very silly. He did not last long the other day. Lots of medkits. Maybe I should be concerned about all these medkits. Certainly Franklin's is a better choice than Haunted Ground. Haunted Ground is an interesting perk, but as we saw last game, if you don't have any other hex perks and never give the survivors a reason to attack totems, they'll never trigger it. chests and blood points. Yeah, as much as Hex Haunted Ground is a cool perk, it needs to be paired with other Hex perks because the survivors need a reason to be going after your totems. Unless, I suppose, the survivors have their own personal reasons to go after totems just in general, which is rare. Raccoon City. A dense and confusing map that I still don't fully understand. But survivors generally think is pretty safe because of its complexity. Hello. Threw a completely different pallet behind me? I have no idea what they were doing there. Pull again. We're definitely showing our inexperience here. This gem has movement. And someone hopped off that cliff. There you are. Isn't there a hole somewhere here? Too late to find the hole of any use. The only reason I caught her is because I heard her breathing. Fang quietly gasped just as I passed by. Nope, too late to bird that one now. It's already done. I'll bird it anyway. The ones doing it are already gone. We found them. And someone went in a locker. But not that locker. Or that one. Huh? Hello. If you didn't start sprinting, I never would have known you were there. Discordance on that second floor generator, which is why it's yellow. So I need to get there because there are multiple serves on it. Or rather, were. He's just being very aggressive. Smoke bomb and a pallet, and now he's back here. Nope. Alright, we kick this, kick this. So he had, what, three ways to inconvenience us, all packed into one? Call that the asshole build. Kinda have to respect it, honestly. That was a chest sound. But where was it? I hear panting. Here we go. Now, it's a bit of a dead end. Through here... there we are. The chase continues. I honestly thought she was crouching behind that, what? We have reached the point where this is a waste of time. Oh. Okay, well, I guess that's where you are. I'm fairly sure this one wants me to chase. Which means she has some kind of plan. Why did that hit anything? There we go. Been a bit since we got it down. You can go right here. And I have gems that I need to address, which I will not address by going that way. That one specifically. No and sneakily hiding around. That should have connected. Now we have Mr. Alan Wake's turn. I would not recommend you play with that window. This is a smarter Alan Wake than we're used to. He did not hang around that window long enough for me to trap it. Yeah, Dead by Daylight, at its core, is just hide and seek with a horror reskin. And the generators are just some generic. Alright, my bird traps do not last very long. They would expire long before. I see you. My birds are giving you away. The window. She's not clearing the birds, which is kind of weird. It means I can hit her again. Continue the bird. And she lost track of where I was. There's someone right next to me. I really don't know what that guy thought he was gonna do. We got more birds, which they wave away immediately by hiding in the locker. Yeah, I saw him just standing in the corner. Don't know what his plan was, but whatever it was, it didn't go anywhere. Bird hits. Survivors are in a tough spot right now. Birding the gems is not giving us any info. Maybe that one way over there. Information. What is it? Valuable information. It is now. You're kind of out of pallets in this whole region, friend. So I don't know what you expect to bird. He didn't go for the bird. Well, now he's going down here. He's not even struggling, and I don't know if I can capitalize on that noise notification that we just received. The level is so dense that, you know, I saw it, and I still have no idea where it was. Was it a loud vault? Was it a pallet? I have no idea. Mr. Renato has died. Which means we are now in Hatch Game. Wherever that may be. And frankly, it could be anywhere. Though, you kind of expect it to be on the bottom floor. Hearing it. Oh, we hear it now. So that ends the hatch problem, and means we go back to what we were doing before, watching one gate and birding the other. I might, but the thing about fanning out the birds is that it increases the cooldown. The fewer birds I send, the faster they come back. She is running out of time. We got her. She's at the far gate. I'm not gonna be able to get there though, so she's gotten out. Yeah, it's open. There she goes. Well done. We didn't even get one pip. Oh, Kate had distortion. So maybe she would have been hidden from her otherwise. Or maybe she would have been hidden from us in several situations that she shouldn't have been. But yeah, how did we miss a pip here? Well, they did heal on us a lot. And we missed... I don't think we hooked the fourth survivor even once. That's why we lost out on Devout. But Gatekeeper, we got Gatekeeper in the bag. That game lasted a good while. And Chaser, our chases weren't that great. We had a lot of very long chases that the survivors basically won. Hmm. No penalty for camping, though, which I'm always proud not to have. But at least we black pipped easily, so no lost progress. Three is where it sits. I think it's time for this guy. I hardly ever play Ghostface, and for good reason. I'm just not any good with him. Increased move speed while stalking seems to be a must. Because this guy relies on his ability to crouch and go into stealth, and doing so reduces his speed. We also increase crouch speed. And then we're looking at, Thrilling Tremors is decent. Furtive chase is, I consider, very interesting, but probably very difficult to use in practice. So let's get rid of Iron Maiden. So it's basically no good. Wait. No, I have that backwards. Iron Maiden 2 is fine. We'll pair it with Darkness Revealed 2. We'll be consulting the lockers repeatedly to find out where our friends are hiding. I only have one tier 3 perk on this guy. That really tells you how much I've been ignoring him. until you cut me off on at every turn, that would run. Fang, Leon, Kate, and Alan. Two flashlights. We have a luck offering, a hidden offering, thicker mist, which actually helps us, and my points offering. We are here at the Ziggurat, the Sanctum of Wrath, perched high on a hill for all to see. But now we are a sneaky sneako. See you. I've exposed you. You are down. And she's staying very close. Probably one of the flashlights. She's still very close. I hear the footsteps right here. Close enough that the lockers have given her away. Excuse me. Please shoot. She wants to play. Nope, not playing with that pallet. I have guessed wrong. But we do cut her off here. Get a second down. There's the rescue. Peek. He doesn't see us. And he has quit. So Alan Wake is now a bot, because he has just rage quit. Hello. The lockers told me you were here. Someone else is here. Oh, that's why she's here. More flashlight beams. Now, where did I leave that guy that I just downed? Here-ish? I don't think it matters as long as this flashlight is still around. And he was picked up anyway. Or got up on his own. That gen is actively being worked on. And you know what? They can have it. It is way too far away to be useful to me. But I still want to see if I can harass anybody. Nope, no one is here. Tell us nothing. Fine then. Keep your secrets. Someone was in a locker that had been given away by Iron Maiden. Went down because of Iron Maiden. Lockers have no information for us, so we greet them. There's the rescue, so we know at least where some people are. We know you have a flashlight, which is why you're hanging around. You also have a flashlight. We have just been double flashlit. Alan Wake is over here, who, remember, is a bot now. So we are currently being played by a toaster. Okay, that was four window jumps. They seem so much like real survivors, don't they? generator sounds. But no one here. Is this where they all are? Hi. Cheap pellets, but doesn't a flashlight, and I've definitely gone the wrong way, but we found a new friend. Someone tried to flashlight the back of my hand. Now she wants to be chased into the shack. To use the shack pellet? No, the window. One tap. Tap. And we now know where Leon Kennedy is. Who has no mither? Hey there, brought you a friend. And Leon seriously jumps off the hook. Try flashlighting. No, no flashlight. Ah, she's healing way off in the distance. Scratches and noises, and here she is. Playing with pallets, of course. And you're out. Not for lack of skill, certainly. That Feng Min specifically was a huge pain. Fair play to her, though. Fair play indeed. Sort of. It kind of went downhill for them once Alan quit. The others were actually fairly skilled. Feng Min especially gave me a lot of trouble, and I didn't see Leon until very late in the game. I hit him once because the locker lore told me where he was, but he had no Mither, so he could just pick himself right back up, while the Fang Min ran around threatening it with a flashlight. So between no Mither and Fang's flashlight, that was a pretty good combo between the two of them. He also had Tenacity, of course. True. Yeah, it was very well played on my part, but they were no slouch either, and I have to give them credit for that. I do wonder if we would have gotten that victory without Alan giving up on us, because Ghostface is not my strongest killer. You'll notice I only caught Alan with the sneak power. Nobody else really gave me a chance to use it. So, what is next? Maybe Cenobite? Maybe Demo? What does Demo have for perks? Nothing terribly interesting. There's always Huntress. My Huntress aim is, frankly, terrible. There is a lot of power in Trickster, and I really wonder what this yellow scar is on him. It's a very strange thing, because it glows. Oh, it's part of that cosmetic. Using Locker Lore, Starstruck, and Mad Grit. A couple of good combos, and my two currently favorite add-ons, More Blades and Faster Throwing. Bright White Plaid is certainly an interesting choice. We have some 47 and some 97. Also a lot of toolboxes. This may be a tougher match. That. He's going to cut that off immediately. I wonder if Alan Wake will throw a Mount Ormond offering to take advantage of the white coloration. Nope, they want the hatch in the shack. Well, let's see if there is a shack, because so far, every time I've seen one of those offerings thrown, almost every time, there's been no shack. And I do wonder if that consumes the offering. Okay, see if we can find a locker to ask it where everyone is. Here we go. Aha! Darkness Revealed has shown us some things. I think someone over here was breaking a totem. Not many other reasons they'd be crouched over like they were. But we arrived too late and see nothing. Hello. He jukes back and forth a few times to try and make me miss, but I just don't swing. And now, surprised he didn't go up for the window. More wiggle jukes that also don't work. You stop that. And that is Mad Grit Starstruck. You get tapped too. You should jump. You should really jump. Look at them all. They're swarming. Now I throw all the blades in the world. And it doesn't quite work out for me. Where did we leave Tap? Tap is... I still don't know where Tap is. Tap got up, apparently. Aggressive bunch of survivors here. I'm gonna reload. This also tells us we have a friend here. back up where you came from. They just saved tap. Oh, hi, who are you? So many bold and aggressive plays just aren't working out. They did break a hook on me, though. So maybe I can't get to this one. Nope. We made it. Give that a kick and go back the way we came, because I heard a boo. But I lost track of which way we were going. This way, I think. There we go. We tracked down the Boon Totem. Poof. There's the rescue. Scratches against the back wall. Target's found. Is okay. I'll just go to this one. And you will go down. More very aggressive sabotage plays. I don't actually have a hook for Claudette. And I can't get her anywhere, so she can go down. Tap has jumped off my hook and broken it. There's a lot of sabotaging going on here. Ah. And Boil Over is just ramming me into walls constantly. Alright, you can go on the round then. I'm not having you jump off my shoulder, you can stay down. No, just let them be bait. Since they've destroyed half the hooks on the map at this point, there is little benefit to picking them up. Thank you. That resets his wiggle timer completely. But they've broken the hook again. At some point, they're going to run out of sabotage. I'm not sure exactly when, but they can only break so many hooks. There goes another one. This is beyond absurd. They're more interested in taking my hooks down than in actually doing gems. Who's going to sabotage to save you? No one. Now Tap is still down. And the hook has come back. And now I need to go see about this and find where these scratches go before this person finds the hatch. Target sighted? They are far out. They might reach the hatch before I do. They very much will. There she goes. Well, that went well. I have not seen that kind of sabotage aggression in a long time. That would be why we had 100, a 97, and a 47. Tap had a map, and we had toolboxes all over the place. Claudette's toolbox was sabotage-focused. Very sabotage-focused. Michaela's toolbox, I guess, was more repair focused, but could be used for sabotage. Claudette also had the saboteur perk for even more sabotage. And we had breakdown on Claudette and Tap. So rescues immediately broke hooks. They were absolutely dead focused on destroying every hook they could. Everybody had breakdown. Boon exponential. Which allows them to... I see the plan here. So they were sabotaging and breaking hooks as much as humanly possible, to make it so I could not get anyone to a hook and had to leave them on the ground. And to prevent me from just slugging and leaving them on the ground, they had this boon totem that gives everyone in the boon radius the ability to pick themselves up from dying. That was the plan. Force me to drop people and allow them to pick themselves up. What a remarkable strategy. Fang, Zarina, Michaela, Allen, two toolboxes and a medkit. Hidden offering. There are very few hidden offerings on the survivor side. Usually hams to protect favored items from destruction, or shrouds to determine how the survivors spawn in. So the fact that they have a secret offering tells us a little, but not enough. We are aboard the Nostromo. Let's see what the lockers have to say. One hit, way off in the far corner. Scratches and a sighting, and someone just popped out a locker, which is a higher priority. Now, where would they have gone? No idea. We gave a fangmin to find a potential Iron Maiden victim, and now we've lost them both. There's certainly an ace up to be had there. Hello, generator noises. But no one is here. I see someone. No, I suppose not. And the lockers tell us nothing. They've already finished a gen, and we've only had a single glimpse. Just heard a totem break. We have scratches, but no evidence of those scratches going anywhere. Another generator. And still not a single clue. I believe the term for this is immersed survivors. We haven't seen us. There's somebody. A third gen. We've made one hit. Okay, three gens and our first down. This game's definitely not in our favor. What? What? Chase music? Chasing who? Scratches? What? So, someone is somewhere around here. There they are. Didn't quite work out for him. I think we're gonna have to be content with getting our challenge done here, because they're already down to one gen. The three gens I cannot defend. I've only got two books. There's another survivor down here somewhere. The one who made the rescue has to be here. No? I hear healing noises, but where? Under the pallet, of course. He hasn't learned that the pallet is not safe. Wait. He had adrenaline, so he got right back up. And I was right. Someone was in one of the lockers down there. I just didn't check all the lockers. They're probably still down there. In fact, left. And now we have this to worry about. Shoo! Oh, don't. There's the rescue. Oh, we're going right back that way anyway. Nope. 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 Take a hit. And it's because of those hits that we make it all the way down here. Are they playing door games? A little bit. You best get out of here. Fang wants that rescue. Keep two. Given how very on the ball the survivors were that game, I'm happy with two. Wow. They played really strong there. Next objective, 15 gold or better. There's an escape as Adam Francis trial back there. Oddly specific. Seven chainsaw hits as Hillbilly, too. Let's stick with Tricky for a bit. I've almost got his first prestige level. That 63 Jeff Johansson could be a threat. Points offerings. Not a good map for Trickster. An amazing map for Dredge. And that's why lockers everywhere tell us everything. Hello. Sure, go for the power. I don't care. You still take a hit. A lot of things to break. Now, where can we put you? Where? More sabotage. I see someone. Yes, I did. That's okay. They gave me a pallet. There we go. Another target spotted. Interesting. I wouldn't have thought she had that much time to charge head on in there. Somebody's in the basement. What are you doing down there? If not charging head on again. Well, that's where the scratches went. I know someone went down here. What is happening? As for you, lead on someone else. It's the Jane. Break the pallet. Huge delay on breaking that pallet. She's throwing all the pallets. And is behind us now? No, she went up. Wants another pallet. Actually, she went down the hole to head on us again. Didn't work this time. I am wise, your tricks. Survivors are diving into a lot of lockers, which is very odd considering that we have Iron Maiden. But now we have this Nia to chase. It is unclear what her plan was. I don't know where that Nia went. Having a bit of trouble, though. No kills, and they're on the last gem. Let's see where they're going, though. I don't know why you're doing- oh, flashback. Good flashback play. Oh? Where is this Nia going? I know she's just wasting time while everyone else unlocks the door for her. So I am seriously playing right into their hands here. And we're out of knives. That did not work out for me. There's still the Nia, and the Jane, and I don't see any lockers to get knives from. And they're all gone. And here we- just go. You don't have to do the whole bad manners thing. This was a respectable group. Yeah, I was impressed with them right up until the teabag ending. Jeff was a ghost. Barely saw him. Prestige 1 Trickster. Oh, just when I was thinking about going Dredge. You can't switch now. We can change our add-ons to be weird. Faster blade reload. Is that just faster locker speed in general? That'd be nice. And then bouncy blades. Blades pierce. That could be really strong. Oh, I thought this was a secret. So somebody has thrown a white ward to protect what is probably a powerful item, or some favored add-ons. Coldwind Farm, more traditional map, insofar as DBD can be said to have traditions. Also, the sun is high in the sky. Is that always like that? Can you still call it Dead by Daylight if several of the maps are daylight maps? Anyway, we've used Darkness Revealed, gotten a glimpse of someone. Heading roughly this way. Kind of have to guess where they are now. And this gen seems likely. Scratches tell us more. And we found it. Track her by sound. She's staying in the air. And hiding. She does not want to leave this region. No idea where she's gone now. Aha! She lost track of us. We've lost two gems for this one down. Not good economy. The lockers tell us about this man. And we get him down with bounces. I hear someone coming for a rescue. Don't know what she's doing. We get several hits here, and I need to reload. I think you missed your timing here. A little bit too bold. Very, very much too bold on every front. So we now have three downs. Because they don't know how to keep their distance from one another. And the fourth one is in a locker. Or was. I don't know where I left Alan. Honestly, I didn't even realize he was down. It seems she knows. And another pallet has been thrown for no reason. They got Alan wake up, though, so not a completely wasted move. Need to reload. The lockers tell us there's someone way back in the corner there. They were injured, so that would be Alan. Is he still here somewhere? Doesn't seem to be. He is, in fact. No, this is someone else. This is Michaela. Yeah. Teabagging doesn't look so smart for you when you're getting completely barraged, does it? Where is she gone? Right here. I think one more knife takes her down. I just need to land it. And I'm out. She's still here, though. And down she goes. Attempted flashlight. Doesn't really work. And the one with a flashlight. Well, that didn't work either. And there's Alan. Again, they are being very dense here. As in, staying very close to one another. I don't really know where they've gone after making that rescue. But I need to pay attention to my generators. Yeah, I know what I said. Lost another gem. And I think I need another reload. Unless 44 is my blade max. Nope, it is my blade max. And this tells us Alan Wake is way over there, but I see you. Which is somewhat more pressing. Are we really gonna play cow tree games? Because that won't work. You can go right here. And I just saw you. Got Michaela down with Starstruck. She was too close when I carried Fang. This will be an ambitious trip to the basement. Which it looks like we pull off. Now we just need to find Alan. And the lockers do not tell us. He's going to want to find the hatch now. Oh, we found him. I don't know what he thinks he'll accomplish by going up here. Maybe hoping I'd fall? I saw the hatch. So you can go down right there, but I'll be right back. He could have gone right in here. It was right there. Based on how much the challenges went up, oh yeah, double pip, quadruple iridescent emblems. Alan even had a key. Wow. Which he could use to see the obsession at all times, and he could channel the key to detect us. And his white ward is defending the key. So even though we got him, he still has this key and its add-ons. I don't think he ever placed the boon. Yeah, he had body knowledge and self-care for improved self-care strength. And lightweight for less scratches. So he had a pretty good build. It just still didn't work out for him. Though it did make him the last man standing, so that must be respected. That was a good game. Kind of an object lesson in survivors being very aggressive and bunching up, and how that doesn't really work out too well. So now we switch to Dredge, like I was thinking of doing. We can abominable snow beast some people. The way my perks are arranged. So we'll just get right to it. Hex Pentimento. I really can't see myself ever using that one. A lot of good stuff in here. And I got all the good stuff. We've been joining this match for quite some time now. And beginning to suspect the game is lying to us. Thank you. I may have to. There's definitely been a bug here. It still says joining match. Ah. That explains everything. Is it Steam this time? It's not Steam this time. I still have a Steam connection. It's DVD itself. Well then. I suppose I was kind of thinking of ending early anyway. And there's something like that, sure. Huh. We're being held hostage. I can't leave. We are now stuck in limbo with the snowman staring at us, unable to play, unable to quit. Huh? What's happening now? Oh! It finally caught up to the problem and booted us out. All is well. Everything is broken. I think that'll do it. It has been a fine Sunday. Some good games, some bad games, some very strong survivors, and some that will be stronger in the future. We'll put it that way. See you next time.